Taiwan conducts anti-aircraft landing drills at its main international airport for the first time. 6 helicopters and 180 soldiers participated in the exercise, which simulated an enemy seizing control of air traffic facilities. The drill is part of Taipei's annual exercises, which focus on protecting infrastructure and defending the island against enemy ships. On Tuesday, Taipei canceled a part of these drills as the island braces for Typhoon Doksuri. A road accident in Lima, Peru, leaves 21 hurt with at least 3 people in intensive care. CCTV footage captured the moment of collision involving 2 vans and a motorized vehicle. At least one pedestrian can be seen narrowly avoiding being hit by one of the vehicles.
The Philippine Agriculture Department assures the public of enough onion supply during the off-peak season. The Plant Industry Bureau says government will be able to secure adequate buffer stock to cover demand for the next 2 months. But the head of the agency admits importation is not yet off the table.
So, ang ating laging aim ay magkaroon ng ganitong supply. So, sa ngayon po ay ampat po ang ating supply, sapat ang ating supply, ang red and yellow onions. And tungkol naman po doon sa importation plan, yes po, meron na po tayo yung ganon. At gaya po ng nasabi ko, ito po ay ating minamanage at patuloy po tayong nakikipagkonsulta sa ating mga stakeholders at mga producers.
Business groups call for better apprenticeship programs to equip the country's new generation of workers. The appeal comes as the Senate Committee on Labor discusses the proposed Apprenticeship Training Act of 2023. The measure hopes to give students the opportunity to be exposed to different work environments through the technical and vocational training. The Employers Confederation of the Philippines welcomes the initiative, but it says the bill still needs a lot of improvements. Like ECOP, the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry also underscored the importance of exposing students to various apprenticeship programs to make them competitive. One example given by ECOP is the automotive industry that could see a job loss of some 2 million workers in the next 5 years. The group says workers need to reskill to adapt to changes in technology following the rising popularity of electronic vehicles.
The architecture for batteries, design and everything would be about 18 months. So we fear that the jobs that will be lost as a result of the inroads in technology over the next 3 to 5. Malaki, Senator, kasi yung ang laki ng shift sa electric vehicles dahil inalis yung taxes, no? And therefore, almost all automotive companies are getting into that. Ang mawawala ng trabaho, yung mga sanay sa gasolina na types of vehicles.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. meets with Malaysia's King Abdullah and Prime Minister Anwar Ibrahim. King Abdullah and Prime Minister Ibrahim Anwar welcomed Marcos and the Philippine delegation in a state ceremony at the National Palace on Wednesday. This was followed by talks between Marcos and the King. Marcos is also holding a bilateral meeting with Prime Minister Anwar, where they're expected to pursue areas of cooperation aligned with the respective economic agenda of both countries.
The Philippine government is aiming to complete its nuclear energy roadmap before the end of 2023. An official from the Energy Department says they're reviewing what will be required to harness nuclear power. Katrina Domingo joins us on the line with details. Kat?
Hi, Denise. The Nuclear Energy Program Interagency Committee is in the process of reviewing 19 infrastructure issues in developing nuclear power, including nuclear safety, grid infrastructure or connectivity, safety, and as well as spent fuel management. That's according to Energy Assistant Secretary Maylene Caponcol, who spoke to reporters on the sidelines of the post-SONA 2023 forum at a hotel in Pasay City. She says the government needs to study carefully and that there should be transparency in the site selection as well as public perception, which in fact the government will be conducting a survey to measure the public perception or the acceptance of the public with regard to the Philippines having its own nuclear program. Now, Denise, as you mentioned earlier, the roadmap is expected to be finished or completed before the end of the year. She says, or rather, the assistant secretary says, Aside from the possible reopening of the Bataan Nuclear Power Plant, the DOE is also looking at smaller nuclear reactors that can be used to produce nuclear power for the Philippines. Among the considerations is the price, because we all know that it's a new technology and that most of it are under demonstration and are not yet commercially available. This is also why that the assistant secretary could so far not provide a ballpark figure as to how much the Philippine government needs to shell out for each small nuclear reactor. Denise, the DOE says they are also closely coordinating with legislatures to come up with a law that will establish the nuclear energy program in the Philippines, especially after President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. stated in his second State of the Nation address that his administration is working to fully electrify the Philippines by 2028. Now, Denise, before we end, just some context for our viewers. The DOE earlier mentioned that the Philippines needs to have an additional 8,000 megawatts of available power in the next 5 years, as the country is expected to increase its peak demand to 25,000 megawatts from the current 17,000. Denise.
Thanks for that, Kat.
Now, in related news, senators are one in saying police officials with supposed drug links or those involved in irregularities should be held accountable. Senate Majority Leader Joel Villanueva says these officers must be charged in court. He maintains resignation is not enough. Senator Francis Escudero agrees, adding that slapping appropriate cases should be the next logical step. Senate Minority Leader Aquilino Pimentel III and Senator Ramon Revilla Jr. both say the police investigation and gathering of evidence must continue.